One important benefit of the FOL concept is that it permits A-10 pilots in training to become thoroughly familiar with the terrain adjacent to the border. Terrain that an attacking force would have to traverse. They know where an attack must come from, where to intercept it, where to conceal themselves, how to take advantage of the terrain. The speed of the A-10 allows the airplane to fly in and around the contours instead of merely across ridgelines. This keeps the A-10 out of the lethal envelope of most enemy gun and missile systems. Faster airplanes are incapable of making steep turns in narrow valleys and sighting targets early enough to identify and engage them. Unlike other airplanes, the A-10 pays no penalty in turn performance at this lower speed regime. The short turning radius permits the A-10 to rapidly take a target under fire, or just as quickly to prevent an enemy from taking an easy shot at him. The A-10 can swing its tail and engine exhaust to confuse heat-seeking missiles, and under pursuit, turn the hunter into the hunted. Presented the opportunity, it can engage thin-skinned MiGs or lightly armored anti-aircraft guns from extreme ranges with a 30mm cannon. The A-10's effective gun range exceeds that of the Warsaw Pact's primary defensive gun, the ZSU-23. Given early recognition, the A-10 can destroy the ZSU with impunity. The A-10 is more survivable than most. It was designed that way. The armor plating that protects the pilot and critical flight control cables which come together in the cockpit have withstood 23 and 37 millimeter Soviet armor-piercing rounds fired at them in tests. Outside of the cockpit, these flight controls are widely separated. So are the dual hydraulic systems that power them. This separation precludes a single-shot loss. Further insurance is provided by a backup manual flight control system independent of hydraulic power. Fuel fires are a leading reason for combat aircraft losses. The A-10 fuel system is protected by foam-filled, self-sealing fuel tanks and external void filler foam for additional fire suppression. Countermeasures carried by the A-10 include an electronic jamming pod to spoof missile guidance and tracking radars. The A-10 has internally mounted dispensers which release flares and chaff separately or simultaneously. The purpose of the flares is to decoy the heat-sensitive missile common to the Warsaw Pact units. The chaff cartridge is designed to create interference at the wavelengths of enemy radar systems. A-10 firepower is awesome. It can carry up to 16,000 pounds of ordnance on its 11 underwing stations. Air Force planners describe a typical anti-armor combat load for the A-10 as being 6 TV-guided Maverick missiles and a full complement of 30mm ammo. This is the most lethal armor-killing load available. The Maverick missile has an exceptionally high probability of killing a tank. While the A-10's cannon has demonstrated outstanding kill power against Soviet T-62 tanks under actual test conditions. These weapons pay the pilot another bonus by virtue of their standoff range. The A-10 pilot can fire either the missile or the cannon and turn away to stay out of the enemy's gun range. Other airplanes... Without question, the A-10 has demonstrated its ability to work under the weather in Europe. The airplane for the mission, with all the qualities to perform it. Rugged, survivable, massive firepower. The A-10 Thunderbolt II. What you have just seen hasn't happened yet, but it could, anytime, anywhere along the border between NATO and the Warsaw Pact forces. If and when it happens, we can be certain of two things only. One, NATO forces will be outnumbered in every category. And two, our ground forces will be given close air support, the closest ever given, from the airplane designed by Fairchild specifically to kill tanks. The A-10 Thunderbolt II. Bentwaters, an air base near the east coast of England. Once an emergency landing field for World War II bombers, now home of the 81st Tactical Fighter Wing. Operational strength, 6 squadrons, 108 A-10s. Mission? To provide close air support to NATO forces where and when it's needed. The only airplane specialized to fight the air-to-ground war. The operational concept of the 81st is simple and clear. Forward deployment, rearward maintenance. Bentwaters serves as the command and maintenance center for the wing. Hundreds of miles to the east, stretching along a north-south line in central Germany, are four FOLs, forward operating locations. One is American, three are German. A-10s and support personnel are rotated to the FOLs to work and train in the area where they would be fighting in time of war. These FOLs are equipped for quick turnaround operations, including fueling, arming, and quick fix repairs. C-130 cargo airplanes bring in parts and repair teams. Normally, A-10s are flown back to Bentwaters for scheduled maintenance, with routine work done at the FOL. The A-10 is ideally suited to this forward basing. It has already established a reputation for the best combat readiness rate of any fighter aircraft. This readiness rate spells constant availability, availability to fly and fight, perhaps the most important attribute a combat aircraft can have when facing the numerical advantage enjoyed by the Warsaw Pact. The A-10 doesn't break as often as the others, but when it does, it can be repaired quickly and under very austere conditions. A-10s launching from these FOLs are only minutes from the border. Armed with six Maverick missiles and nearly 1,200 rounds of 30-millimeter cannon ammunition, the A-10 can range over 150 miles, stay over a target area for 2 hours, and return with an ample fuel reserve. If need be, the A-10 could be landed and operated from dispersal points close to the front, points such as 2 to 3,000 foot runways, civilian as well as army strips, or improvised locations such as stretches of Autobahn highway. One important benefit of the FOL concept is that it permits A-10 pilots in training to become thoroughly familiar with the terrain adjacent to the border, terrain that an attacking force would have to traverse. They know where an attack must come from, where to intercept it, where to conceal themselves, how to take advantage of the terrain. The speed of the A-10 allows the airplane to fly in and around the contours instead of merely across ridgelines. This keeps the A-10 out of the lethal envelope of most enemy gun and missile systems. Faster airplanes are incapable of making steep turns in narrow valleys and sighting targets early enough to identify and engage them. Unlike other airplanes, the A-10 pays no penalty in turn performance at this lower speed regime. The short turning radius permits the A-10 to rapidly take a target under fire, or just as quickly to prevent an enemy from taking an easy shot at him. The A-10 can swing its tail and engine exhaust to confuse heat-seeking missiles, and under pursuit, turn the hunter into the hunted. Presented the opportunity, it can engage thin-skinned MiGs or lightly armored anti-aircraft guns from extreme ranges with a 30-millimeter cannon. The A-10's effective gun range exceeds that of the Warsaw Pact's primary defensive gun, the ZSU-23. Given early recognition, the A-10 can destroy the ZSU with impunity. Naturally, the A-10 will take some anti-aircraft hits. The density of the enemy missile systems, anti-aircraft guns, and airborne interceptors makes it clear that all NATO aircraft can expect to take punishment. But the A-10 is more survivable than most. It was designed that way. The armor plating that protects the pilot and critical flight control cables which come together in the cockpit have withstood 23 and 37 millimeter Soviet armor-piercing rounds fired at them in tests. Outside of the cockpit, these flight controls are widely separated. So are the dual hydraulic systems that power them. This separation precludes a single shot loss. Further insurance is provided by a backup manual flight control system independent of hydraulic power. Fuel fires are a leading reason for combat aircraft losses. The A-10 fuel system is protected by foam-filled, self-sealing fuel tanks and external void-filler foam for additional fire suppression. Countermeasures carried by the A-10 include an electronic jamming pod to spoof missile guidance and tracking radars. The A-10 has internally mounted dispensers which release flares and chaff separately or simultaneously. The purpose of the flares is to decoy the heat-sensitive missile common to the Warsaw Pact units. The shaft cartridge is designed to create interference at the wavelengths of enemy radar systems. A-10 firepower is awesome. It can carry up to 16,000 pounds of ordnance on its 11 underwing stations. Air Force planners describe a typical anti-armor combat load for the A-10 as being 6 TV-guided Maverick missiles and a full complement of 30mm ammo. This is the most lethal armor-killing load available. The Maverick missile has an exceptionally high probability of killing a tank. While the A-10's cannon has demonstrated outstanding kill power against Soviet T-62 tanks under actual test conditions. These weapons pay the pilot another bonus by virtue of their standoff range. The A-10 pilot can fire either the missile or the cannon and turn away to stay out of the enemy's gun range. Other airplanes, which must rely on free-fall bombs, expose themselves to enemy fire when they fly over the targets to a release point. Another benefit of this forward-firing ordnance is that it doesn't require any critical launch conditions, such as a prescribed altitude or airspeed for release, nor does it require exact distance for accuracy. This suits the low-weather flying conditions of Central Europe. Low ceilings often prevent the use of bombs by preventing the airplane from flying at the proper release altitude. Weather severely limits the ordnance loading for most other aircraft. As the visibility decreases, further limitations are imposed on faster and less maneuverable aircraft. The diminished visual range prevents them from engaging a target unless it is almost directly on the nose. Most of the time, this means maneuvering for a second pass. And this probably means never seeing the same target again. Without question, the A-10 has demonstrated its ability to work under the weather in Europe. The airplane for the mission, with all the qualities to perform it. Rugged, survivable, massive firepower. The A-10.